Hello, localizers. Hello, everyone on the internet. Hello, cat about to jump on the desk. Today we're going to be playing A Link to the Past for the Super NES. We're playing the English version, but is there music on?
Little bit.
Okay. But we're going to be playing with a special programming thing on the side where shows the Japanese script. And I'll talk about that in a bit, but here's what we're playing. I'm just going to stick it here.
Where's Epona? I don't want to walk around this field.
Here we go.
Even that disappears a little.
We own it. It's legit. So before we begin, I want to point out that I'm going to be talking about the game as Zelda 3 a lot, and I think that might show my age.
A lot of
But
people, well, a couple people get mad at us when we call it
because
that.
everyone knows it as Link to the Past, but I know it as Zelda 3, and there's a reason. Is it's because for a long time all the magazines called it that.
There you go.
Ta-da!
Zelda
This is from
3.
Nintendo Power.
There you go.
I have to learn the controls for this. So I'm not crazy. It was Zelda 3 for the longest time. So a lot of other people who anticipated it, we were always talking about Zelda 3 to our friends.
Even me, who played A Link to the Past for the first time in 1998, I still called it Zelda 3 because I knew there was a 1 and a 2.
But I don't think I ever called anything beyond that by their number. I didn't call Link's Awakening 4. I think I saw it called 4 once, and that was it. We'll be taking a look at various things like this, various publications.
Hey,
Here's it's the Link to the Past.
is that the commercial or is that just a new
It's just a
thing?
random thing.
Oh, okay.
Wow, that is green. But yeah, here's the old Nintendo Power. This is also, I think, around the time they started doing
Oh yeah.
these
We have the
Zelda, Zelda. Wow.
We have that whole book.
Oh yeah, that's right, we do. So we'll look at this as we're playing. And while I was at it, I pulled this out. This is something we picked up for the surprisingly the Earthbound book. This is one of the official strategy guides,
By
Japanese.
ape.
Yep, by our friend Ape over here. You know, it's the guys behind the Earthbound games. And I was skimming it, and you can see they still call it Ganon with two N's there in the Japanese version. I think this is the first time that they fixed it as Ganon with one N in
Yep.
English. And
Oh, now that's from the commercial.
so Ape is really famous for its unique strategy guides. They're not so much guides as like experiences that augment the game. So you can see they even include a lot of stuff from the commercial. You can see Princess there.
Oh yeah, Ape is like well known in Japan for their guides more than anything, right? Maybe?
I would say Mother series.
Ah.
Here, you know, you got Link dancing. There's even a part in here. Well, actually, let me show you why.
Oh yeah, I remember.
You guys might be surprised, but ta-da! Here's Link.
Praying to Jesus on the cross.
So what is Hyrule's Jesus' name?
Well, it has three goddesses. Well,
This predated that
Ocarina of Time, huh?
yeah.
Aghanim?
Aghanim. So there's even a part in here where it talks about us. It talks about how the game is received in America. It talks about Nintendo Power and how, like, over here it talks about how the that comic was in the Nintendo Power.
I need to look through that.
Here's the guy who does that comic. He looks like Einstein,
Let
Japanese Einstein.
me see. He looks like Doc Brown.
Okay, one of those two. They even interview our good friend Gail Tilden, who I think
Hey.
we have mentioned helped us with the Earthbound book.
Yep.
I even showed her that, and she got a kick out of it. Hey, look, it's Final Fantasy IV. So anyway, we'll take a look at this stuff as we're going through, but I think that's it. I think we can start the game.
I'm gonna do my shout
Right.
outs. Sins of Science and Augsburg and H-Hog and Wild Rumpus and Ficina, new face there. Boa Transistor, Bubbly Oasis, Nintendo, Never Been Christ, it's been a while. Itinerant Soldier, Lago Morph Ball. Farnberry. Don the John the Don, I'm gonna mess that up every single time. An Insane Ostrich. And Simon Sanchez. Niada. I'm just gonna start repeating people's names at this point.
So we can start now.
Okay,
All right. Here we go.
And Kyo is here.
Whoa, Kyo's here.
And HD Blackstar. Hello.
Hello, all. All right, so here we go. You're going to see...
I want to see the whole intro. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And see over there on the side is where we're going to do our stream magic for today. That was really cool back in the day, seeing like 3D like that.
Mm-hmm.
It was, you didn't really see anything like that at all.
Cool.
Hey, it's the thing behind us. So you can see on the side as this goes, it's going to mess up. There we go. I just now got this intro working on here. And you can see I can scroll it up and down if I want.
Nice.
So this is, it pulls the script from the Super Famicom version, the Japanese script. There's also the Game Boy Advance version, but apparently the Japanese Game Boy Advance and the English Game Boy Advance versions, they have, they apparently have very different texts, like it's been edited a whole lot. And I really want to get my hand at it, you know, grab it and check it out. But apparently those are encrypted. Huh. In some weird way, and nobody has broken the encryption on the text yet. So I'm sort of taking it as a personal challenge now.
Ah, hello, 211. This is the Zelda that refers to the MC Hammer in the Japanese script.
Yep. Maybe it will show up when we finally get it. So since the Game Boy Advance version is so different, and I don't have, you know, access to it right now, I'm thinking, what, maybe down the road in a few months or something.
We'll just play it again.
Yeah, we'll play it again. Maybe I'll do the reverse where you play the Game Boy Advance version and it'll show the American English version.
So the Game Boy Advance Japanese?
Probably English.
Oh, okay.
And it looks like the GBA versions have some sort of like piracy protection stuff, so the ROMs will often crash.
A little hyperbound.
Which makes it real hard to
program for. So Spartan Barry says the GBA version adds some kind of Riddle Guy side quest.
Yeah, there's like a whole bunch of new stuff like that, and that text is right out there in the open. You can open it with the text, you know, just like Notepad.
Oh, I have the GBA version, but I was like really excited to get it because it's my favorite Zelda game. It's what got me into video games, like severely got me into video games. But the sound.
Yeah, there's a patch to get rid of.
I had to stop playing it because when you go to the Dark World, that sound it makes, I couldn't stand it. I had to stop.
So, since I've never played the GBA version, I would really like to someday. So, the whole point of why we're playing Zelda is, you know, we played this a million times, right?
Mm-hmm.
But I'm constantly writing about Zelda. I'm writing books about Zelda. Like, we have a Zelda 2 book sort of in the works, and we're already talking about doing this one. But I need to become a real master of Zelda. I need to know all the stuff about every game. I need to have that knowledge in my head. So, we're just going to play these on and off during our future streams. All right, so let's begin. Alright, so let's do a new one here.
So Itinerant Soldier said I never played the GBA version just because of all the bad stuff they heard about it.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not bad, but if you can play the original, just do that.
So you got this, like, weird targeting system in here. It seemed to make more sense in the Japanese one. I was, like, really confused on why they would have this.
Yeah.
It's like, why can't they just have a cursor, but...
I didn't know how to use it at first.
In the Japanese version, it's real nice, because you have to, like... traverse many, many more characters.
Call him Zelda.
Let's just go with... I'm just go with standard Link.
I definitely did not... Oh, it's uppercase all?
Yeah.
I didn't Pretty know sure. his name nope. was Link.
I can go back. How do I do that?
My cousin had the manual. Because I got this game in a pawn shop, so I didn't have the manual or anything. And then one day my cousin brought it over and like, look, his name is Link. I'm like, no, it's not. It's Zelda.
Yeah. So even though I've written books and like gigantic articles and things like that, every once in a while on Twitter I'll be like, you know, why isn't Zelda, what if Zelda was a girl or something like that? And people really get angry and they try to correct me about it. All right, so here we go.
All right, Lonk.
And I don't really need to get screenshots for this game because good old King Darien... like about a year or two ago, he went through both games and got a whole bunch, so I got most of them.
Oh, Life Forcer? Should we bother voicing any of this?
Sure.
Help me. Please help me. I am a prisoner of the dungeon of the castle. In the dungeon of the castle, my name is Zelda. The wizard, Agnum has done something to the other missing girls. Now only I remain. Agnum has seized control of the castle and is now trying to open the seven wise men's seal. I am in the dungeon of the castle.
Didn't she already say that?
Yeah. You gotta reinforce it, you know, because you're just waking up.
So in Japanese, it looks like he's called a priest or something and not a wizard.
Mm. Please help me. Here you go.
Lonk. Lonk, I'm going out for a while. I'll be back by morning. Don't leave the house.
Do any other Nintendo games, SNES games, use that font in here?
I don't think so. I was wondering why that wasn't doing anything.
One thing I always like to do is to never open that chest.
Really? What's in it? The lamp?
The lantern, but you can get that in the dungeon later.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I just like to have that chest, like, unopened all game.
Everyone has, like, their weird little rituals. Quirks, yeah. What are you doing up this late, kid? You can stay up when you're grown up. Now go home. I see you brought a map so you don't get lost. Press the X button to see your map. You can see the word push in English there.
This is very strange because it's making me think about my original experience with it. When I didn't know much about top-down games, I didn't know about games with stories, didn't know about RPGs or anything like that. This is my very first one.
So I've noticed that all of these guards, each time you talk to one, they'll say something new until it loops around.
Really?
But each one says, like, did you know that at the end? In Japanese.
Right there?
Yeah, it doesn't say that in English. You look strong for a kid. How much can you lift? That seems meme-worthy.
Do you even lift,
press
bro?
The A button while touching a thing.
What?
To lift it.
Hello, Kevin Chai.
I'll bet you can't wait until you're old enough to use a sword. Press the B button to use your sword when you get it. As you can see, like, the Japanese is much simpler. There's nothing about getting old enough.
Mm.
It just says when you get the sword, press the B button to use it.
Well, I guess how will these soldiers know that you're going to get a sword?
Yeah. And in Japanese at the end there it says, don't forget that.
Itinerant Soldier said, I didn't have an SNES, but I remember getting the Nintendo Power with a full article on this, and I was like, darn, this looks cool. Why'd I pick the Genesis?
Yeah, I'm lucky that I didn't choose something like some weird system. Okay.
Kyo says he's never talked to these soldiers before.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You can talk to the soldiers. They won't attack you yet because they have no reason to.
Mm. I never talked to them before. I was like, oh, those guys look mean. I'm staying away from them.
So I did know that the GBA version has, maybe not for these guys, but it has some extra lines of text in the game. There's all kinds of stuff I want to learn about the GBA version. So we'll do that a different day. Okay, they've looped around. So, I gotta ask.
What?
For you guys out there, do you see 8? The number 8 on that? That's all I ever see when I see these. It just makes me think of, like, an 8 ball.
Yeah. That's I always have. But next time, don't do a leading question. Say, what do you see?
Oh, okay. What do you guys see? Undo. Press X.
We could be watching you live translate Phantasy Star 3 right now? What? Okay, they see the 8. Always.
So when I open the map, it pulls up the script. I gotta fix that in the future.
I really like the thunder sounds in this game.
It's real good. It's not that really fake one, too.
I will give 100 rupees to the man who finds the descendants of the wise men. Signed, the king.
So in Japanese it says, whoever finds the girls with the blood of the seven sages. So it specifically says girls at this point, so you kind of know something's up with a bunch of girls.
Hello, Neo Repo.
And those are hearts?
Yeah.
You think that's on purpose? Or do you think it's just a pattern?
No, there's no way they could not make that on purpose.
You can read that.
Nah, I already did. Help me. I'm in the dungeon of the castle. I know there is a hidden path from outside of the castle to the garden inside. Cool.
Hey, hey. You're not allowed in the castle, son. Go home and get some sleep.
No.
We'll go over there. Is there anything over here?
You're blocked off, but you can see what's over there.
I played A Link Between Worlds 3 times for localization purposes. And so I sort of remember stuff from here. Oh, it's just the same stuff.
So, Ficina always saw a bee on those
rocks. Really?
Oh,
okay. So what is it supposed to be? It's such a weird pattern. Everyone misreads it.
Zelda sounds like Nina. Yeah. From Breath of Fire. Crocky has never actually finished A Link to the Past. Oh. The farthest they got was stopping... was the Moon Pearl on the GBA version.
The GBA version just defeats everyone?
It's just...
So the Moon Pearl, that's not that far in the game, is it?
No, that's like the third dungeon.
Alright. Here we go. Here's Uncle. How long is this? Okay.
Long. I didn't want you involved in this. I told you not to leave the house. Take my sword and shield and listen. You could focus power in the blade. Hold the B button. Then release it using the secret technique.
Whoa.
Handed down by Kefka, our people.
Thank you, Coffee Goat. You actually spooked me.
Thank you for following. Lonk, you can do it. Save the princess. Zelda is your...
So you can see in Japanese, it sort of ends the same way.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of people are always just wondering what Zelda is. Like, people thought maybe it's like your sister or something like that. And
Destiny.
But Japanese... Like, the word order is flipped, so there's not really that. Mm. So I did a whole article about that on Legends of Localization, if you want to check that out.
I always figured it was Destiny. Like, you're just walking on him. They becomes part of the background.
They totally changed the line in the GBA version I checked.
Really?
Yeah. They make it much wordier, and they make no... I don't even think that's in there.
Breath of Fire and A Link to the Past had the same voice cast.
So there's that Ancient Stone Tablets, like the satellite game that recently got a fan translation, right?
Mm-hmm.
They should totally have hired you to do the voice of everything. We got the lamp.
I'm still available if you want a second version.
Does also in here it says to use the Y button. Wow, it didn't say to use the Y button. That's interesting. In Japanese it did. So this game has been picked apart and has been fully like disassembled and hacked up and down and left and right. So there's probably not a whole lot of new stuff that we'll find as we play this. But like I said, it's sort of just for us to learn and master. Last time we played this together was like 5 years ago, right?
Did we play this?
Yeah, we played it together, remember? And we had like hot chocolate month or whatever.
Yeah, the next game was supposed to be Zelda 4, but we never did it. I just called it Zelda 4.
We did get pretty far. Actually, we did finish Link's Awakening.
But then we never did Ocarina of Time.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, there was one point a couple, I want to say, I don't know, 75 years ago by now, where we wanted to play through the entire Zelda series. And we got
That's what we're doing now.
Yeah, we got up to the sleepy one. What is it?
The sleepy one? Link's Awakening?
Yes.
Yeah, we finished that one, and then we didn't move on.
Yeah. The Chris Houlihan room. I have a great experience with that, but we'll talk about it if we accidentally trigger it.
Yeah. So I'm not a speedrunner. I've played this many, many times, but I'm definitely not a speedrunner. I've played it like maybe every 4 years on average. So I'm going to suck. Be prepared for the suck.
You don't have to kill those, they won't fight you. Only the ones with the long swords will fight you.
See, I'm learning.
You didn't know that?
Nope.
Oh! So
I'm just a killer.
If you have the little sword, they'll just look and run past you, but like, the long sword, they'll look at you and then they'll chase you.
So is it the sword or the color that I can easily tell?
The sword. If you go back in that other room, I can show you.
It's okay, we'll keep looking. See, I'm learning things, you guys. So press the X button.
Yeah, I liked Wart in Link's Awakening. Hello, Yubleton. Why can't we have a Zelda Cross Chrono Trigger game? That would be kind of cool.
Okay.
Did you hear that?
Chrono Cross?
Zelda Cross Chrono Trigger.
Oh, like a crossover?
Yeah.
Yeah, that'd be cool. I thought you were talking about a Chrono Cross Zelda game.
I don't know if I'm supposed to say X or Cross in that situation.
This game has probably been, it's been disassembled and, like, you know, examined so closely. Actually, I'm going the wrong way.
No, you're doing okay.
I gotta go this way. But I wonder what the speed run is at this point.
You could have gone up there and then...
I know, I was going the direct way. Ah, crap.
Look what happens when
I'm using,
we both know this game.
I'm using the totally official Xbox controller.
It's like, hey, you should do it my way.
Yeah.
Oh, Luigi blood.
So I really like this top-down style of Zelda. You know, Zelda 2 is okay, but I really like how they came back to this.
Yeah.
But it's really funny, like, to make it look like this, they have to... Everything's at a weird angle, so you actually get to see that in A Link Between Worlds. Everything is basically, like, tilted. You okay?
I don't know how to pronounce that name. Ill Temple? Hello. Let me know if I mispronounced that. I probably did.
I thought something was wrong with... You were sick or something, and it was just you couldn't pronounce...
I just couldn't pronounce this. I had to get up close. And hello, coffee goat. Hello again.
So I only spent a couple hours programming this script thingy, so it's not fully tested. So if my computer crashes and blows up, you know what's up.
Just Temple is fine. That makes it so much easier. Thank you. Will we do Legends of Localization on Chrono Trigger sometime? Asks Yubleton.
You mean a stream? Oh, I died.
Oh, no! Now you're going to have a 1 by your name when you...
That means I'm number 1.
That game over screen looks different. Game over looks different to me.
Does it?
Maybe I just don't remember. Maybe I didn't get a game over.
I don't know if the controls are messed up or not, but like I have to press select to make that go.
I think that's normal. RIP 000.
Oh no, I don't really care about that. I was testing the game over screen, that's all.
So Crocky remembers seeing an LP of this game, but it started on April Fool's. So instead of starting normally, he glitched straight to the end of the game in part 1. RIP Lonk.
Every time I die, we have to donate 1 book to charity.
Hello, Dr. Smith.
I'm kidding. I don't even know how many books we got.
I don't think charity wants books. They want some money so they can do their...
No, a person named Charity.
Ah.
That's a good way to get around, like, having to give stuff to charity.
I didn't know anyone named Charity, but I knew someone named Cherish.
Wow.
And there's that Madonna song called Cherish, and I used to just sing that to her. And, you know, she always smiled politely, but I wonder if she got tired of it after a while.
Bye, everyone.
Hello, Nalwonk. A lot of new people today.
Ah. It's a little hard to control.
Ooh, that stereo system.
With this Xbox.
Oh, that's right. Wait, don't we have a Super Nintendo hookup?
Well, my script scrolly thingy and other such uses the controller also. I was looking into foot pedals, and it's going to be a pain to set those up probably. So 1 minute, 36 seconds.
Yubel says, a stream or a post on the site would be great for Chrono Trigger. Like a whole stream of it? We might, yeah.
I wouldn't mind doing that.
Does it have a pretty bad translation?
No, but a lot had to get cut out.
Oh.
A lot got changed, you know. That would be a good 2-month stream, probably.
And then we could see what it was in Japanese.
Yeah, we'll just take a look, depending on how this does. But I'm really wary of committing myself to RPGs. Because we've learned that sort of the hard way. You don't... Or what are you wearing? Oh, that's Star Trek.
Yeah.
You got the big key.
Yeah.
Man, this game is a great game.
Because the necklace looks so good against this red shirt. It's like I'm in the command position.
So this would be a good situation for the Zelda Link or Zelda Chrono Trigger crossover. Do you talk to her or do you get the treasure, you know?
Isn't the treasure just rupees?
I care about the money today.
Thank you, Lonk. I had a feeling you were getting close. Up there just says Link.
Yeah, I just put Link up there.
Lonk, listen carefully. The wizard is magically controlling all the soldiers in the castle.
So yeah, it's Priest Aghanim.
I fear the worst for my father. The wizard is an inhuman fiend with strong magical powers.
So he says demon. She says demon in here.
I didn't know the word fiend when I first played this, so I thought it said... They misspelled friend.
Yeah. I like when you learn English from games like that. Mm-hmm. You know, you learn grammar and words. I learned the word farce from Final Fantasy III for Super NES.
Do you understand?
Not at all. Oh, it's the same thing.
So Coffee Goat wonders, how did you get the script set up here?
I was going to do an article about it for the Breath of Fire 2. Like, we did this for Breath of Fire 2 last month.
Mm-hmm.
I want to do an article on it. But basically, I have a program that reads the emulator and sort of just, like, hacks it and pulls out the information. It's a very dangerous program.
Hello, Dian. All right, let's get out of here before the wizard notices. I know a secret path, but first, we have to go to the first floor. Let's go. But first, we gotta go to the first floor. First.
I love this song. Yeah, I'm gonna try to do a whole article about how I did the Breath of Fire 2 one. Maybe after I finish each game, I'll just do a little, like, final look.
So Lagomorph Ball said I was never into books, so most of my literacy and vocabulary is probably thanks to RPGs.
Yeah, I spend all my time translating, like, entertainment and, you know, games and, you know, anime and stuff like that nowadays, so it's like most of my Japanese I know now is from that. So I know all these, like, words for demons and fireballs and spell names.
Life Forcer asks a good question that I don't know the answer to.
What is it?
Or even considered. Is that the first floor in the American sense or first floor in the British sense?
Oh, that's a very good sense.
What the heck? Is first floor in Britain like the second floor?
Yeah.
We have like bottom floor and then first floor is the second?
Yeah, there's a whole like section on that in that Japanese book I gave you about the numbering system of floors is a little different in different countries, especially Japan. So what does it say in the map here? So I guess it's just marked, so it's not a big deal. But let's take a look and we'll see. Oh, it looks like B1 is just the first one underground.
Okay, basement.
Yeah. Because what, like the first floor for a lot of places is called ground floor in others or something?
Ground floor,
and then
yeah.
So the next one up is one or something like that?
Mm-hmm.
I know going down it's also a little complicated. I haven't thought about it in so long that I'm probably forgetting something.
Hey, British people, do you guys ever have a floor 13 in, like, hotels or office buildings? Because we don't. They skip from 12 to 14, even though we know
that is the dumbest thing.
There's a 13.
Are we still, like, living in the Dark Ages?
Yeah.
Oh.
There's a secret passage in the throne room that leads to sanctuary.
It just says church in Japanese.
I'm sure the old man there will help us.
The father? Like, the priest?
Oh. That's cool. And Coffee Goat says, I love your stream layout. If you want any custom pixel art UI stuff, hit me up.
Oh, yeah.
And then two smileys.
Okay, cool.
Did you leave the castle?
Yeah.
What?
I want to take her on a date.
I've never done that before.
See, look at these hearts. I got to show her how strong I am.
See how his sword is small there? He won't chase you.
Well, he's chasing me.
No, he's not.
He was.
Mm-hmm. He was just walking towards you.
Okay, so let's go back. But yeah, you can see that little Triforce thing down in the corner there. That's actually a pixel art that I had commissioned for a Link Between Worlds section I was going to put on the site.
Oh, yeah.
I never made it. There's a couple pages already finished, but, you know, maybe I'll use it for stuff like this. Oh, here we go.
That ornamental shelf should open. Do you have a light? It's pitch dark inside, and you can't see without one. If you're ready, let's go. Help me push it from the left. This part always confused me, because I was, like, just standing in front of it and trying to, like, push buttons, even though I read what she told me to do.
I want to have a thing like this in a future house we live in, like a secret room. And you have to push the fridge out of the way or something. And that's where we do our illegal ROM hacking.
Wow, so Nawong said, in Canada, the only place I've ever seen a 13th floor was a government building. Shaman Sanchez says, don't some buildings actually use the 13th floor for utilities and things?
Yeah, that's what I've heard.
Okay. So how do you get to the 13th floor? It's not on the elevator.
There's probably a certain button you can press if you... I always liked these little snaky guys. The ropes, I guess they're called in this one, too.
Yeah, the ropes.
Rope snake. So with Breath of Fire 2, you know, I gave us super experience and super money to get through the game more easily, but in this I'm not going to really hack the difficulty.
Hello, CBJ. Another new face. Welcome, and Fox Egg, hello.
Alright, let's get this guy. I'm really glad that it doesn't always tell you, you know, use this in the door. Because later Zeldas, they're very message heavy.
Yeah. After passing through these sewers, we will be very close to Sanctuary. I always put the in front of that. I never knew
there were. There's a couple situations like this, a couple typos also that got fixed in the GBA version.
I can understand. Let's be careful. I can understand why they wouldn't do that, knowing what Sanctuary, all the different meanings of it. You gotta keep your utilities nice and haunted.
Alright.
How much is a yellow rupee worth again? The Kappa face. There is a yellow rupee, isn't there?
Isn't
it? Is it gold?
Isn't it 100?
No, 100 is silver.
Is it? Okay.
Hello, Starbits.
I think we have a yellow rupee in our Zelda book. With it saying how many rupees it was. It's from, like, one of the 3DS ones.
10 is blue. 5 is 1. Green is 1. Blue is 5. I guess 10 is yellow. 10 started in the Twilight Princess. What happened?
I'm pressing the wrong button.
Oh. Gold is 300. Red is 20, yeah.
I gotta check my controls because it's confusing me.
I don't know, Alexpert. I'm streaming. My brain went away.
There we go. My select and start were swapped.
Oh, okay.
I was so confused. Nice. Ooh, I can control the game.
The ice cave in this game is the worst? That's my favorite dungeon.
I remember I was stuck there for the longest time.
The ice palace.
It was like one of the first times it was like a 3D puzzle
that
I had experienced. I guess I got 0 bombs. Okay.
I love the boss in that dungeon. And we see Kappas in there.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
I didn't know what they were. I just called them ducks.
So if we were ever to do a book for this game, which I would really like to do, I kind of want to go through every Zelda game in order.
Yeah, that's great.
There's so much we could do, you know. Like, I totally forgot there was Kappas. There's a lot to this game.
I wonder what they call them. Because we don't have, like, a monster book in this one. Sanctuary is just beyond that door. Pull the switch over there. Do you want to pull the wrong one? Oh.
Pull the lever to open the door.
Press the A button and hold down on the control pad.
You should do that in real life. Just talk to me and be like, hey, you can operate this by pressing the yellow button.
There's another trick too. So like if you had walked over here first, they wouldn't have given you that message. Then this is the correct one, so then they give you that message to tell you how to operate it. I know too much about this game, but probably not everything. Oh no! Get that heart, get that heart!
I'm playing with a handicap here with the Xbox controller. So besides the script comparison, I wonder what other stuff I can pull from the game and show on the side there. Because there's not a whole lot of text in this game. Princess Zelda, you are safe. Is this your doing, Lonk?
Yes, it was Lonk who helped me escape from the dungeon. When I was captive, the wizard said, once I have finished with you, the final one, the seal of the wise men will open. I don't think Zelda would voice act.
So in Japanese it says, when the final, when I sacrifice you, the final, you know, make you the final sacrifice. So they took that word out.
Lonk, you must not let the land of Hyrule fall into the wizard's clutches. If he releases the seal of the seven wise men, evil power will overwhelm this land. Before that happens, before it's too late, destroy the wizard before he destroys all of Hyrule. You can do it. You can.
Uh-oh. My thing broke.
Oops.
Alright, we'll pull that up in a second after this.
I sense a mighty evil force guides the wizard's actions and augments his magical power. The only weapon potent enough is to defeat the wizard is the legendary Master Sword. It is said that the village elder is a descendant of one of the seven wise men. Maybe he can tell you more. I will mark his house on your map. but watch your every move. I am certain that the castle soldiers will be looking for you now.
Oh, that was the priest the whole time. Here you go.
I will hide Princess Zelda here. Do not worry. Seek the elder. So I think either there was a weird character in Japanese that I didn't have in my font, so it crashed the program. Mm-hmm. Or maybe this text was just so long.
Oh.
Because it's a pretty long line. Also, it made that sound that might have screwed it up. Okay, do I understand? Yes.
Hello, Jason.
Okay, so let's do this.
We got a suggestion from Jason.
Okay, what's this?
Could you make the sidebar show things like enemy names, location names, etc.?
I possibly could, but I don't know how to do that.
It's different when you're not in battle and yeah, the enemy name is like. Right,
I mean,
there.
I guess I could, like, I could do something like that. It might be kind of fun. I'll give it a shot. But actually, what I need to start doing is focusing on. I think we might do Techno Seeker of the Stars next, so I need to start programming that stuff.
Hello, Shirokoma. Hi guys, can the PS4 controller be used for wired PC gaming? I'm pretty sure you can. Use
it. Ooh, it worked. My heart, little heart
oh,
things
cute.
Over there.
Oh, cute! You found a heart container! Your heart level increased! They capitalize a heart.
Yep. So the reason there was two hearts in the Japanese thing there is because the heart icon there is actually two letters, technically. I don't know how to do half of a heart.
Hello, Brinty.
Let me talk to these people. I better talk to my pals.
Lonk, be careful out there. I know you can save Hayaru.
So she says, be careful, Link. I will stay here and be praying for your well-being.
Meet the elder of the village and get the Master Sword.
This was such a level up from the other Zelda games.
Absolutely.
Like, even story-wise, like, almost every Zelda game after it sort of was based on this.
Mm-hmm. So, the Japanese version of this is called Triforce of the Gods.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, we couldn't say God.
Mm-hmm.
And do you think titling it A Link to the Past kind of... Was it supposed to be a surprise that this was a prequel?
No, because right in that thing I was showing you where it calls it Zelda 3?
Yeah.
It explains it.
Okay.
Here, you can read it. Let me pull it up.
Okay.
Let's see. I think it's this one. So we are reading from the Book of Nintendo Power. And it's going to be backwards for you. And this is the first preview, I guess, for Zelda 3. For Adlas the Third. So, would you like to read that?
Yes, but first, Yubel wants to know, what is the worst translated game you have played?
Besides, like, the super obvious ones, like, where it's just, like, on purpose?
Yeah.
They were
really trying hard.
Breath of Fire 2 was really high up there. Probably one of the most notorious, but also, I've played a little bit of Legend of Dragoon, and it's really, really funny.
All right. Zelda 3. While Nintendo Company Limited is being extremely secretive about the third game in the famous Zelda series, we have heard that it should be completed by August, with a scheduled release date of winter 1991. From what we've seen of Zelda 3, all we can say is that it looks awesome! The gameplay viewpoint harkens back to the original Legend of Zelda, but has a 16-bit graphics that will allow for larger characters and enemies, as well as greater depth and realism. 16-bit scaling technology is used to zoom in and out on the overworld. The story behind Zelda 3 links with the past in that the hero is an ancestor of Link, also named Link, and the main maiden he must rescue is an ancestor of Zelda. Not only are the objects in the world huge, but the world itself is gigantic, with many items to find, people to talk to, and secrets to discover. Link has more amazing abilities than he had in the other Zelda games, and the plot and story are also more involved. Be sure to stay tuned to Nintendo Power for the inside scoop on this super game! 16-bit technology!
Yeah, there's like the whole part about the overworld scaling. There's not really a big deal.
No. Oh, hey Zooli, I didn't know you were there. I was trying to put the magazine on the cat.
So this always reminded me of the happiest after I played Earthbound. It has that little dot right there in the forehead.
I never quite knew what this thing was, because I played it on a very small fuzzy TV, like 13-inch TV. Hocus pocus!
No, you didn't say anything about taking rupees. There should probably be a number there, but I didn't program the number thingy.
Okay.
So, never mind that.
Mario must venture forth and defeat the evil power of Jumping Board.
So I asked about that the other day. Like, I could swear there's multiple versions of the English Super Mario Brothers manual, and one of the versions has like a bunch of the enemy names all swapped around. And so we need to start buying all those on eBay, all the English manuals we can find.
Of Mario?
Yeah.
Okay.
And the Duck Hunt ones, too.
We've got...
Yay!
A couple coming.
My face has worked.
Wanted! This is the criminal who kidnapped Zelda. Call a soldier if you see him. That ain't me. You know, I got pink hair, so I'm cool.
So this is, in Japanese, basically Wanted. This is the criminal who kidnapped Princess Zelda from the castle. If you see him, shout. So I've always been curious about this. Is this just like... this roof always is...
I always thought it was grass.
Yeah, it looked like a big bush or something.
Spartanberry says, how many Athena manuals did you have to buy again?
Oh, yeah.
Wasn't it four?
We might have four, maybe five.
A couple of them came with the game itself. Yeah. Just one of the manual. Hello, Aquas.
Yo, Lonk. This house used to be a hideout for a gang of thieves.
Now, is this... I always saw this as like an old grandma. How are they speaking here?
It's a man.
Okay.
What was their leader's name? Oh yeah, his name was Blind, and he hated bright light a lot. So in Japanese, his name is indeed Blind. But in English, it's kind of obvious, you know, from the name.
Oh, so it's Buraindo?
Yeah.
Mm.
All right.
See, because doesn't that kind of look like an old grandma? Like the hair parted and you imagine it's in a bun. Oh.
Yeah, I wouldn't have thought of it until I saw... Yeah, I would have thought it was probably a woman until I saw the Japanese text. I'm burping.
This game is just too much for you.
Oh, this one I always get confused with.
Don't
this.
Go back up because then all the...
Oh, really?
Can I do it?
Pode, show us your powers.
Oh, boy. I don't remember quite. Uh-oh. Oh boy, this D-pad.
So why does Link have pink hair in this game? I think you're getting that. And then you can push that and that.
Yeah.
Oh my god, Poe.
Uh-oh, but I can't get the... Yeah, I can!
You're the Zelda goddess. Oh.
You got bombs yet?
No.
You know the secret place you can usually get bombs?
Where?
There's a place in the grass.
Show me this grass.
Okay.
I only know about Pokemon.
Dang it, this D-pad.
So Starbits thought that was always a librarian.
Oh. Yeah, it looks like one.
Now Wonk says, my grandma says yo all the time.
So, sometimes the bomb doesn't appear.
Okay.
And go, Link. Wow.
Yeah.
Xbox.
I think I'm going to switch the controller out tomorrow.
Okay. Down in this area. Let me see.
Well, yeah, I think I will sometimes try to farm bombs in this area. Just running back and forth.
Around. Yeah, there we go. I got a bomb. I'm going to go blow that up. See, because these are bushes here. See,
Yeah, you're right. Like a hedge?
Yeah, a hedge. Maybe it's like...
Uh-oh.
Maybe it's made out of like brick and hedge stuff because it's a thief slayer and they don't want to be noticed. I never thought of that.
Yeah, I don't know.
They just want to blend in.
Yeah, we have a USB SNES adapter. But my program on the side there, I have it hooked up to the Xbox controller, so it's just handy to have both at once. Probably tomorrow I'll make them both work. So is it every Zelda game where the bomb will hurt you too? Or are there some where you don't? Like Zelda 1 doesn't hurt you, right?
In Majora's Mask you can hold up your shield and be fine.
Oh, okay.
You can also, I No, that's with the bomb mask. The bomb mask, you get hurt when you use it, but if you hold up your shield and use it, you're fine.
Okay,
here you go. You can have it back. Hello, Mr. Scootman.
So, like on a actual TV, I never really noticed the pink. It wasn't as strong and vibrant. Yeah.
When I first got on the internet on my first Zelda forum, I remember somebody talking about Link's pink hair, and I'm like, "What are you talking about? He's got red hair." What?
I just assumed it was like, for some reason, I always assumed it was part of his hat.
Yeah. It moves though when he walks, barely.
Alright.
Okay, yeah, it'll hurt you.
Yeah, so whenever the heart icon shows up in a text box, it's going to have like either a heart or I put fractions in there. It didn't look very good though.
Oh, it's you, Lonk. What can I do for you, young man? The Elder? Oh, no one has seen him since the wizard began collecting victims. Now, is this the wizard from The Wizard, the little kid who got 50,000 in Double Dragon?
He's actually a terrible villain. He's a kidnapper. So, once again, there's a priest and sacrificer in here. He's been collecting sacrifices.
What? Master Sword? Well, I don't remember the details exactly, but would you like some cookies?
I would.
Long ago. I don't remember the details, but let me get into the story. A prosperous people known as the Hylia inhabited this land.
Yeah, so it's Hylia in Japanese also.
Legends tell of many treasures that the Hylia hid through the throughout the land.
So are the people called Hylia? Or did they ever change that in the later ones?
Hylians.
Hylians? Mm-hmm. Okay.
The Master Sword, a mighty blade forged against those with evil hearts, is one of them. Please say that...
No, people.
Oh, people say that now it is sleeping deep in the forest.
Okay, yeah.
Do you understand the legend?
In Japanese it said, did you hear everything? Let's just say yes.
Anyway, look for the Elder. There must be someone in the village who knows where he is. You can take care now, Lonk. You take care now.
Hmm? Wow. So all of that is there. All that text that she just said?
Uh-huh.
Was there's like four lines of Japanese there?
No, there was a longer one, wasn't there?
It was before that.
Oh. So Alxprit, we're getting some pronunciation stuff here.
Okay.
Oxford always pronounced it Hylia.
Me too.
And so did Coffee Goat. I never did. Hylia.
I called it Hyrule and Hylia or Hylia.
I probably called it Hylia because of Hyrule. All
right, who can we talk to without getting alerted? He's not here yet, is he? The old man?
No, I don't think he ever comes back here.
Oh, we have to go find him.
I know where he is. Do we have to, like, find him? You, sir, have you been going through life without one of my amazing hold-anything bottles? Well, step right up and I'll make your life complete. I've got one on sale right now for the low.
You look at it, it's like, you can tell the Japanese is not that crazy.
For the low, low price of 100 rupees.
Say
no.
So he's speaking sort of in a way in Japanese that's sort of associated with Chinese people trying to speak Japanese.
Years ago, I was
Chinese.
What do you say? Interested? Don't need it. So you're broke, eh? Too bad. Come back after you earn more rupees. It might still be here. Oh, I thought he'd give it to me for 50. Is that a different game?
I think if we talk to him again, no.
Alright, might as well get it. Hello, Nuka-Cola. Where you been, dude?
You missed all of our crazy shenanigans last week. We were just talking about Breath of Fire 2 earlier today.
So Yuga wants to know, could the pink hair be a Super Nintendo palette limitation?
It's probably. I get the feeling it was more like what they did with Mario's mustache, where they needed something to make it look distinct.
Because it's like, he's had his orange here, so if you made it...
brown, or...
Because his hair used to be brown.
He already has, like, the brown on the side of his face, yeah. So it looks like maybe he has a beard and hair.
It would have made sense, though, if they just made it blonde, but they went with pink. Goodbye. Thanks a lot. Goodbye. Now hold it above your head for the whole world to see, okay? It's good for business.
So this is where it all started, wasn't it? No, I guess it started with Zelda 2. No, Zelda 1. Never mind. It started with Zelda 1.
This is a magic bottle. You can store an item inside and then use it later.
In Japanese, it says this is a bottle. It's not a magic bottle. Paul, we have many bottles. We should sell them for $100.
No. Now, what are these here? What do these look like to you, these?
I don't know, mushrooms?
Thought so, yeah, mushrooms.
I don't really see anything in them. They just seem like...
Because this kind of looks like a tree trunk there, but they always look like mushrooms.
All right, let's go in this heart house. It's a Mario. I mean, it's Hario.
I never saw that as Mario. Someone pointed that out to me. I'm like, what? That's not Mario. They're small trees.
Somebody left food on the table.
Budding mushroom trees. Sense of science. That's correct.
All right. I'm having my stream brain emptiness, so I don't really know what to do next. Okay.
Hi, Lunk. Sorry about my yard. It's a little overgrown. Thanks for visiting. I'm glad to have company to talk to. I will tell you an interesting story.
Why does he have all these beds?
There is a lake swimming with Zoras at the source of the river, but it is hard to find. Just follow the river.
I see an XXX there. What's that about?
The treasure of Zora can turn people into fish. I'd love to see that.
I wonder what... Wonder what's going on there in the Japanese.
Is it an item?
He's talking about hearsay about some item that is very XXX-y. And then he's like is sort of like embarrassed laughing, and he wants to check it out. Yeah, he wants to see it. So I wonder what that's about.
I don't know.
Yeah, I'm gonna check that out. Have I played this in Japanese? I don't know. I guess this is the first time. Well, sort of playing it in Japanese.
My son really liked to play the flute, but he went to look for the golden power and has not returned. I wonder where he is and what he is doing now.
He has a bee. Started frying.
Whoa! I saw her!
Sorry.
A very nice... Lonk, you should... A very nice young lady at the Waterfall of Wishing in the...
Yeah.
Hills where the river begins. Lonk, you should meet her. You should meet her. At least once. I'm sure you'll like her, son.
You can see the number one there in the Japanese script.
Yeah, the Ocarina story.
So you see this bar. This is a bar, right?
Like, I think so.
You see it way much more in Link Between Worlds. You have to come here a whole lot.
You gotta, like, go behind there. You can go you can go in the back.
Yeah, I forgot there's a secret. Uh-oh.
He's fine. He just runs from you.
I don't want him to. I was gonna kidnap him. Alright. Oh, this is where this started.
Itinerant soldiers, so they looked it up, and the... consensus is that Link has pink hair because of a color palette limitation.
Okay.
Specifically, that the brown hair would blend in with the background and look weird.
Yeah.
Hit the cuckoos. Actually, how do you pronounce that? I always called it cuckoos.
I think I call them coos.
I can't go out because I'm sick. People say I caught this cold. From the evil air that is coming down off the mountain.
Oh. Thanks for following Yoshi83X. So in Japanese it says... it's talking about like the monstrous energy that's flowing from the forests and the mountains, not evil air.
Oh. This is my bug-catching net. I'll use it when I'm better, but for now, I'll lend it to you.
So in Japanese, it's totally different paragraph. So he's saying, everyone is saying that I've probably been done in by the monster's energy.
Is he going to die?
Cough. But when I get better.
Mm.
I'm going to use this bug net when I got better. Oops, I didn't read the rest. Oh, well.
You borrowed a bug catcher net. There may be some other things you can catch with it, though. Two.
In Japanese, it says it's a secret.
Yep, we got a Super Famicom.
So there's
Kukos, Kukos.
This was really the era of people just having fighting about pronunciations of things like chocobos. That was a really long one.
Chocobo.
So it looked like this guy had a totally different line of text in Japanese or an extra one.
I hope I get well soon.
I'm just going to stab everything with my sword.
Ficina just called them death chickens.
Bye-bye.
Jokobo.
Oh, look! The rumors say you kidnapped the princess, but I still trust you.
Why isn't he living here? Why is his house, in the middle of the forest with his uncle? Hey, you got some bombs?
Yeah, he, lives in the middle of nowhere for some reason. No, get out of here.
Sins of Science says, as a kid, I pronounced chocobo, chocobo. I await your derision. Derision? How do you pronounce that word?
Is it getting meta?
Yeah.
Derision, I'd say.
Derision?
Derive.
How do you pronounce... Vid Strickland wants to know. I always said Sahasrara.
Sahasrara, I think is what I say. Mm. But I've never really talked about Zelda to people in real life.
Oh, I talked about it with my brother a lot.
So, I know I'm going slow, but I'm...
That's fine.
This is the criminal.
More Satellaview games are getting dumped.
Ooh, that's
says
nice.
Life Forcer.
Yeah, I really want to check out those the Mario collection or whatever. All right, here we go. We're going to do this. Here I come.
Hey, here's Lonk, the Wanted Man. Soldiers, anyone, come quickly.
All right. Here we go.
Sorry, kitty.
Get ready.
I scared our cat awake.
So basically that woman is responsible for that soldier's death. I hope she's happy. Let me in.
So Vid can't remember how they pronounced it as a kid, other than hilariously wrong. That and agonym.
So I've already been here. Here's the wanted man. This was a really cool mechanic they had. This also reminds me of before Metal Gear. I guess Metal Gear stuff had already happened before this, but this...
Technically.
These Zelda games have this stealth element to them, mm-hmm. even this far back. So I've been there. I've been there. I feel like there's one place I haven't been.
You missed a place.
Oh, I've been in... not here.
Hey, Lonk, Elder, are you talking about the grandpa? Okay.
So I think there's two lines in the game in Japanese where it becomes clear... Or they specifically refer to Link as male, and this is one of them. He calls him Link Oni-chan.
But don't tell any of the bad people about this. He's hiding in the palace past the castle. I will mark the spot on your map. Here you are.
That sound effect worked. May I help you select the thing you like? Press the A button. Prices as marked. Prices as marked thing is not in Japanese.
Nah. That's a weird... That is a weird term, phrase to put in here. You can blow up a wall all the way to the left. If you get the bombs from the grass.
I thought that was already as far as I could go.
I think you gotta...
Oh, wait, yeah.
They're up.
I can just go buy those ones. Get over here.
The bomb is not there today. You caught a fairy. Keep it in a bottle. That's also the first time I saw fairy spelled that way.
I think they fixed that in GBA version. I think they
probably.
I think they do it inconsistently in this game.
We can jump into the cavern on the top left for free bombs.
Oh, that's right.
Forgot about that.
It's kind of interesting how whenever I stream, my brain goes away. So now it feels like this is a fresh game to me. Like I haven't played this game before.
Boing. Yeah, it's not technically wrong, but it's weird and archaic. Hello, Alias.
I got a bomb.
They said when I was 13, my brother and I got into a trivial brotherly dispute over who got to play Link to the Past some evening. He threw a chair at me.
Whoa.
And I smothered him with a beanbag chair. Needless to say, we both got in trouble and no one got to play.
Wow.
Oh my god.
It's like, I really enjoy hearing people's gaming stories like that, their memories.
Did anyone else fight with a sibling like that over who got to play a game?
See, video games do make kids violent. Just a different way. So let's go bomb this village. We're like a wanted criminal.
I think it's 7 hearts, Elkspert, yeah.
I've stolen stuff from people here. I've stabbed people. I've killed people. Now let's add bombing to that list.
So do you know much about Final Fantasy VI and why the Tonberry was called a pug?
I don't know why.
Okay.
Is there a reason why? Like.
No, you will just wanted to know.
Yeah. Not quite sure why. That's something that'd be really cool to ask Woolsey, but some stuff like that maybe you don't know, remember, after however many years.
Lifeforcer got into a fight and broke their copy of Crash Team Racing. How did that happen? Yeah, there's plenty of bathrooms in games.
So as we're talking about destroying games, I had like an on and off love-hate relationship with Zelda 2 for years and years and years. Like, I hated it, but then I would like always want to give it a good try.
Mm-hmm.
It would repeat like that for years. And then a friend of mine I met, and he wasn't very fond of Zelda 2 either. So we took his copy of Zelda 2 and we smashed it with a hammer.
Oh!
And just the cartridge, just like the guts came out, you know?
Yeah.
And then we would play that in the NES. I'm thinking we should do that for a Zelda 2 book and just have it, like, reenact that.
We do have plenty of copies of it.
Oh, yeah.
The world's not going to miss one. CBJ said, my grandma liked watching me play this game when I was a kid, and she wanted to try one day. And she started yelling at the soldiers, asking them why they were so angry and to stop poking her.
Oh, that's great. Right, if my lost partner returns, we can temper your sword, but now I can't do. If that sentence ended there, that'd be great. Anything for you. I wonder why they took out anything there. And he's got some terrible, like, surgery tools here.
See you later, Nowonk. Starbird says, my earliest fight got my secret of mana file deleted. Or mana. I always said
mana. Yeah, I always said mana, too, yeah. But I'm trying to not be a bumpkin.
Yeah.
In these modern era.
You can... Oh, really? I never tried using the hammer to help him with his...
Oh, really? I didn't know that either. Wow.
Yeah, you can do... Let's do that.
We're doing that later.
Man, there's so much we're learning already.
Mm-hmm. See, I'm glad we're doing this. Maybe we should just go back to Zelda 2 and people can tell me stuff. Alright, I can go a little further down, it looks like. By this point, I'm usually in the first palace. I'm just really slow. Wow, this controller. Whee!
Do we have a better controller? Like, can we hook our PS4 controller, or does it have to be
wired? I think you have to get some sort of drivers and stuff for that.
Mm. Oh man, I have a story about this.
We'll do that later. Yeah.
Let me hold the controller and reenact what I did.
So I'm having that problem when you get married, is when your memories start to like merge with your spouses.
Because you share stories so often.
Yeah. So I have a story about that too, and I don't know if it's my story or yours.
But we'll find out.
We'll get to it when we get... I like how this guy looks at you. Hello, guy looking at me. Yeah, Lonk, now I'm quarreling with my younger brother. I'm in the chat and I'm going to throw a chair at you. I sealed the door to his room.
Hello, Speed Beats. I got my brother's Game Boy taken away because I whined when he wouldn't let me watch him beat Final Fantasy Adventure. Aww.
Wow. I remember that. I remember the day of, like... trying to watch people play games on Game Boy?
I remember my brother whining about something, and then my mom would take it away from both of us when I was behaving. Hey, Lonk, did you come from my older brother's room? Is he still angry? Go back.
Actually, let me read that again. Okay.
Go talk to
him. Meow. Yeah. So the doorway is open again. Okay, okay. Maybe I should make up with my brother.
Hey, Lonk, did you blow a hole in my wall?
I'd be angry if somebody blew a hole in my wall.
Dian said, sometimes I wish I had siblings, and I hear stories like that, and I'm rather glad I don't. There's something, because you can fight with a sibling. If you can reach the goal within 15 seconds, we will give you something good.
I don't have confidence that I can do it with this controller.
Yeah. Because, like, you can fight with a sibling. What? Yeah, you gotta do it.
Right now?
Yeah.
Oh, wait, let me read that again. Yep. It just, like, I could taste the Japanese line in it. Bye.
Did you want to do it?
You can do it.
Okay.
I forgot that there was a sign there. Yeah, I do want to check out Final Fantasy V, the PlayStation translation, because some stuff is super literally translated without context, and it's really hilarious. Oh, yeah.
Yeah! 0 minutes, 10 seconds. You qualified! Oh. Congratulations, I present you with a piece of... heart!
You think it has a chopped apart...
beef heart.
You don't need to get screenshots.
No, I okay. was trying not to fall off the cliff.
Okay. I found a piece of heart.
I didn't know that you could use those dots and jump over it like that. Mm-hmm. My cousin had to show me. So I think I managed to get there by using the Pegasus boots and like going all the way around.
Yeah. So I've done all of this. Gone in there, gone in there.
If this was Breath of Fire 2, it would be Lonk obtains H. Did you get the update for the new AC New Leaf yet? The new Zelda stuff is awesome. Hello, T the Hero. No, should I update my New Leaf? Because I left that town in the dust. I'm pretty done with it. Pretty done with that game. But do you think it's worth picking back up again? When did they start to call them heart containers, said Shirokoma?
The first game?
Okay.
Then they started calling them pieces, right?
Heart pieces, because the pieces are the little pieces, right? And then the big ones are the containers.
Do they still call them containers, though?
Oh, I don't know. It's been a while.
I feel like that would probably be something that would have been phased out by modern ones.
Hello, Botman R. So it's very worth it to the hero? Oops.
It's because there's probably...
This way to Lost Woods? There's an arrow maybe?
There's probably something in Japanese that I don't have in my font. I thought I tested everything. Aw, crap.
They weed your whole town for you. And you could sell your whole town and... What? You can just start over. You can start over.
Alright. Let's not read that sign.
But I don't want to start over. I love my town. My town's called Chiptune.
I bought the game and then I played it for like 10 minutes.
I kind of really, really convinced you to buy it. Mm-hmm. And you didn't want to.
And I called it Murka.
Yep. Your town was Murka. You would only buy things that would make sense in Murka.
Yeah. Thanks for following, Looney Tick. That's a game I would really like to play on stream someday, is Goemon 64.
Yeah. They're absolutely still called heart containers.
Okay. That's cool to know.
Beeline can come to your town if you have a Monster Hunter amiibo.
Is that a thing in America?
Maybe I need that.
Oh, I'm stuck.
So, Spartanberry says, in a randomizer, I got the Titan's Mitt before the Magic Mirror or the Moon Pearl. Do you think I could soft lock the game at this point?
Probably.
You can hit select, save, and reset if you get stuck in the dark world? Okay.
Seeing this, like this mist and everything, it was really impressive back in the day. Love that song.
Mm-hmm.
Oh crap, there was a thing in there.
Yeah, sometimes. Is it like a dude?
I just took his heart, like I killed him and his heart just fell to the ground. So, I come out of there, right?
Yes.
Alright, now we can go.
Do we want to go to Sahasrara?
Oh, I hope he doesn't crash my program. Shoot, I'm scared to check any signs now.
Was it the arrow?
It might have been. I thought I had the up arrow working fine.
There was no arrow in that other sign, but there was a down arrow.
No, I mean in the Japanese one.
Oh.
I was going to have a thing also where there's like only maybe like 300 lines of text in this game. So I was going to have like a completion rate where it would say like if I've seen a line, it would add it to the number. But I think that would get a little ridiculous. But it's a thing we could do for future games maybe. It's a walking bushy.
Oh yeah, from that game about moms. Danger! Do not enter Death Mountain without the king's permission.
So in Japanese, it's not called Death Mountain, it's called Hebra. Hebra Mountain?
Really?
Mount Hebra.
Is it always called that?
I think, starting in this.
Even in Ocarina of Time?
I'm not sure about that. But here, I think it's called Mount Hebra. And I think it's probably called Death Mountain, maybe, in the Dark World. I forgot about these guys.
Yo, Lonk, a mysterious fog has recently fallen over the forest. We have to be careful.
Yeah, they speak with a sort of a dialect.
Maybe it's nothing, but this tree feels kind of strange as we cut it.
The Starbit said the Lost Woods blew my mind so much as a kid, I made my parents come in and sit to see it.
I've done that so many times. I did that with Star Fox. I went outside and got my dad, and he was doing chores and stuff. Brought him in, and he was like, oh, that's good. So in Japanese, at the very end of this line, they are making, like, working sounds. Well, not here.
Heave ho.
Yeah, basically. Ah!
House of Lumberjacks, A Bumpkin and B Bumpkin.
Well, now that I know how to crash the game easily, I'll test it there.
Okay.
Oh, wait. I need to close this text sign. Box.
Okay.
Oh, man, I want to know what their names are. We'll find out in the future one. So
have we played Terranigma for the Super Nintendo?
Nope, but that's going to be someday for sure.
That game was translated in Europe by replacing the kana with alphabet letters, so the text looks like
yeah,
this.
Yeah, it's crazy, yeah. All these signs have crazy text.
Oh, it's Death Mountain in Ocarina of Time. Good, that's the way it should be.
So I wonder what's up with this Hebra. I guess we'll find out.
Is there a glitch with that tree? I know you run into it later when
yeah, you're gone. Yeah, you run into it later. What are you doing in that bush? Are you peeing?
Are they working? They are working hard.
They're cutting hard. Oh. No. These were all left by what, the Hylians? The ancient ones?
The wise men? Actually, I never thought very deeply about this story, like, of the past of the story. Mm-hmm. So I don't know.
They were saying something about how the Hylians left treasures.
Ooh! So Luigi's Blood says, one thing I can say about A Link to the Past, the Master Sword is called Excalibur in the French version.
Wow. Man, that's why
that's a serious change.
When I do these books, I definitely want to start looking at international things, yeah. like what we're doing with the Mario book.
I have to stop myself from singing the Excalibur song.
I translated that show and it got annoying fast.
He's always walking around like chanting it.
All right, so here's oh crap. It's gonna be where you started. But I have to, like,
Whoa. Oh, Jesus.
I thought I got caught.
Thank you for following Speed Beeps. It's going to be where I start. What do you mean?
Pose start.
Oh, yeah, the ghosts. I think.
You have to. Yeah, don't I need the good thing?
I thought you just needed to push them. Oh, you go get behind them and pull them.
Oh, that's right. Here we go.
Nope. I'm wrong.
I think we need the mitt.
Push it. There you go. There I am.
It's you. You're not purple, though.
No. Look, you can see bones. The one thing we forgot how to do in this game is to move the graves.
What the heck? What's wrong with me? I feel like I'm channeling a parallel universe version of me.
Ocarina of Time was written to be the series' origin story before they decided to retcon that with Skyward Sword. I wish they would stop doing that.
I wish they would stop doing, you know, timelines.
I wouldn't mind if these were just like, you know, the Star Trek, the different series of Star Trek. Mm-hmm. Or like Final Fantasy. Everyone is its own unique story.
Well, until they start doing sequels.
Yeah.
So I know that this whole area here has beta screenshots that are different.
Really?
All right, here we go. It worked. So it seems the up works.
Not arrows.
All right, let's go this way.
Oh, is that how you can get to that room earlier? So the guys who were cutting that tree face away from the tree and put a bomb in front of Link. He will fall back into the hole.
Holy crap.
Let's go try that.
Wow.
I didn't know that.
I didn't think about, like, there's all these probably tricks and speedrun things that people know about these days. What should I get, Poe?
Wait, what are we doing?
Just buying one. Do we want one? Do we want blue?
That heals both magic and health. We don't want one yet.
There's still too many hearts. Fairies. Yeah. Hello, witch.
Double, toil and trouble. Fire burning, cauldron bubble.
What did it say there?
It's not. Most of it is just weird chanting. And then she's saying that she's making a mushroom. She's making the magic potion out of mushrooms.
Making mushroom brew, I am.
She's definitely not doing that, that witch
double,
saying.
Double toil and trouble.
Welcome to the magic shop. Yep. The waterfall of wishing is up just ahead.
Breath of the Wild is set shortly after Ocarina of Time on the Zelda timeline.
Timeline, go home.
You're drunk, timeline. Go home.
Like, if they had made an actual, like, long story and, like, a history beforehand for the whole world, that would be great, you know? Yeah. Like, you're playing this episode of the world's history, but it just feels like they're, like, making stories and gluing it.
Are we going back to the trip?
Yeah.
Okay.
What time is it? Oh, we better...
Yeah.
I want to maybe... I don't know if we're going to get to the first dungeon in time.
No.
All right, good.
We can talk this hospital.
I was so worried that we would be finishing this game in like 3 days.
What? This game long, and we talk a lot.
Yeah. I need to heal. Wow, controller.
Breath of the Wildfire, the next Zelda collaboration.
Oh, no. All right, please heal me, Sanctuary Man.
He'll heal you, right?
The power of Hyrule Jesus. Yay!
Do you think we can fit God Jesus Robot in the new passport? Would it even be necessary?
If OG-san is holding it.
Ah!
So we're working on the Mother 2 passport, where it teaches you like some basic Japanese and how to play Mother 2 and get a lot of out of the script. So we have all kinds of goofy pictures in there, too.
Ouija Blood says, I want Breath of the Wild so much, actually, and I'm not a huge Zelda fan.
Yeah, I really look forward to it. It looks like a lot of stuff is new and fresh.
Wait, that's the one for the Switch, right?
For both.
Oh, good. Well, I ain't gotta buy a Switch.
Well, we're probably gonna get one anyway.
Yeah.
But it's like, I don't want to play both versions of Twilight Princess, and now there's the HD version. Oh, crap, there's so many... Wow, that was cool.
GameCube one's better.
Yeah.
Oh, shoot.
The only thing I liked about the Wii version was that you could point the...
Yeah.
The arrows.
The arrow. That would make it a lot easier.
But it. I didn't like the swinging motion.
Yeah, because it was just like, weren't actually doing anything. You were just like...
Yeah, you could just like put it in your mouth and go, yes. All right, so put a bomb here and then fall back.
No, like I guess stand right there.
And then fall back in.
Put a bomb in front of you there. Maybe. I hope I'm
remembering. I think this seems...
You have to do it backwards? Okay, I'm wrong. Go back. Go behind it.
I don't know. You guys know? Tell me what to do.
I think you're doing it right. We just have to do it from the right angle. We did it wrong. Or maybe it doesn't work.
I would like to make this happen. But I need to get a heart. Don't be anything bad here.
This might be explained on the cutting room floor. With the HD version, you can use the Wii controller's gyroscope to aim arrows and stuff.
That's nice.
Oh, the tree needs to be open first? Well, yeah. Oh, okay. I thought you could do it now.
Yeah, that would have been a really cool trick. So people are finding some really crazy tricks with the first Zelda. Ah, crap. So, I'm looking forward to seeing the crazy stuff that people come up for this game.
Boy, Crocky, I don't even understand what you just described. I still love that time they killed an enemy by setting a fire in the grass, jumping above it, and using the updraft to get above it and fire arrows? What game are you talking about?
It sounds
about?
Like Breath of...
Breath of the...
Breath of the Fire?
Best of the Worst?
Yeah. There's a new one of... New half in the bag.
Half in the bag. Guys, there's new half in the bag. So, like, when you're done watching us, you should eat some dinner and watch half in the bag. Redlettermedia.com.
Unless you're in a different time zone, and then you should eat a bread.
So I think a lot of people are in a different time zone than us.
Yeah. Okay. We're on our way to... Dungeons.
Legend of Zelda Breath of the Fire 2. Yeah, Crocky. I don't like that Link is a righty, and I can't put into words why I don't like it. It's just like, he was a lefty from the start, and I like that it was established that he's a lefty, this is what makes him different. And no, he's not.
So these Octoroks suck in this game.
Yeah, I didn't even know they were Octoroks.
They suck. They screwed up. Somebody make a hack to make these guys better. They were so iconic in the first game.
Yeah.
In the second game, at least they still looked kind of like Octoroks.
The trees cut down in the Dark World, Yubel, I think, once you get to that and then come back. So Speedbeat says, I would love to watch Half in the Bag, but Doctor Strange doesn't come out here until January. Dang, where are you from, Speedbeats? Is Doctor Strange even out here?
Yeah, it just came out. Ah, crap.
Well, that makes sense, because they reviewed it.
Alright.
They need to be the size of Octoroks and Wind Waker. You mean those big guys in the ocean? I will soothe your wounds and comfort your weariness. Close your eyes and relax. That's my favorite fairy design, with the little thingies here.
Oh, yeah.
I like that.
They look crazy in Ocarina.
Yeah.
What were they thinking? And I remember seeing like a beta version of a normal looking fairy in that game. Man, I feel like I was just here playing all Link Between Worlds so many times. But my memories of where to go and what to do come from that game now. So I'm like, should I be going here right now?
Really? You remember Link Between Worlds?
Like going here and trying to get all the secrets. All right, here we go. Here is... is he just like a really tall, bald, have really tall
forehead? I always thought he was wearing a hat.
Me too.
Wait a second. What were you just talking about? Because I have some thoughts. What did you say?
Link Between Worlds memories.
That's right. I knew this map when I played Link Between Worlds, and I kept trying to go places that were like cut off. Mm-hmm. So I was like getting upset.
All right. Don't crash. Yes.
What kind of voice should I give him? He's a pretty important character. How does he speak?
An old man.
The head is friggin' bald.
Conehead. That's right.
I am indeed Jehoshua, the village elder, the descendant of the seven wise men. I smoke a lot. Oh, really, Lonk? I am surprised a young man like you is searching for.
The sword of evil's bane. Not just anyone can use that weapon. Legends say only the chosen hero who has won the three pendants can wield the sword. Do you really want to find it?
Yeah, of course.
So,
what does it say here?
In Japanese, it's more like, do you want to take the challenge? And just say yes and of course in Japanese.
Good. As a test, can you retrieve the Pendant of Courage from the East Palace?
Is it called a palace here?
I think they're called temples, yeah. Mm. It's not a pendant. Well, I guess that would work.
What is Sahasrara's Japanese name?
I think it's the same.
Oh. They made it look really exotic here.
So he doesn't call it the East Palace at all. He just calls it this palace.
Mm.
If you bring it here, I will tell you more of the legend and give you a magical artifact.
So that makes sense then. Do you think they changed that to make it more obvious for the English audience?
The East Palace?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. He doesn't say he's going to give you an artifact in Japanese.
Hmm.
Now, go forward to the palace.
Who came up with all the names of the Link to the Past dungeons? We're going to find out. I know who. What do we got?
Let's see, we got this Japanese guide here.
Oh, yeah.
There's actually two of these. This is part two. Oh. I think they break it into like light world and dark world. So I'm looking at, it's going to be backwards for you guys, but they have like big old chapters for each area. So that one's called Ganon's Tower, and they use like a real life castle. Turtle Rock. This is interesting. This is called Misery Mire.
Yep.
But I think that's from the English game, right?
I don't know why I know it's called Misery Mire. Did somebody say it in the game?
Yeah, I don't know. In Japanese, that word never appears, really.
Is it, Markule?
No, it's just, like, Swamp of Demons. So, it's interesting that they're using the English names here. Ice Palace. Mm. Oh, you know what? At the end, when the credits are scrolling, like, how many times you die in each area?
Oh! Doesn't it have that? Oh, yeah. And I know they call it Turtle Rock in the game. I got a story about Skull Woods, let me tell you. I can't wait till we get there.
All right, so do I want to bomb in here? I feel like there's a... I shouldn't.
Oh, Dian, I think our camera... Do you mean our camera's flipped?
Yeah, when it's down in the small one, we flip it for audio purposes. So this always looked like a peace sign to me.
Mm-hmm. You bombed it.
I feel like I shouldn't for some reason. Like, there's this crap in here.
You could use the Pegasus boots to get in there.
Well, that's good. I got some bombs.
Mado, could you do a Silent Hill comparison of the English and Japanese?
Holy crap, I've only played like an hour or two of that game, so I don't know. I'm not good with horror games.
Yeah, it would be tough though with, how would you get screenshots easily?
Well, I would hook it to the capture card, mm-hmm. and then I'm going to have to find a program that will let me take screenshots.
Nahal Wonk said, I thought it looked like a skull. The crack.
Oh, really? I just noticed that there's like,
This is the Wii version of Legends of Localization face cam.
Yeah, you're right. So if we play, Twilight Princess, he'll be left again.
Yeah. Dian has a suspicion that all of the Japanese names in Zelda games are pretty bland. What was their Octorok called? Like Octorok, right?
Yeah, it's just Octorok. Yeah.
I have a feeling they're okay. What are them there? Why do we need those? Those look weird.
Armos?
No, these things.
Oh.
These eagle things.
Yeah, it's from old Hylian Chozos. I feel like there's something south that I need to get.
Later.
Like down here. Or maybe I'm thinking of Link Between Worlds where I had to come here a lot.
Yeah, I think so. You had to come up through here to get here, I think.
Get out of here, Octo. Octodad. Like there was a cave over here?
Mm-hmm.
And why? Oh crap, yeah, you do have to come here a lot. Yeah, I remember this part.
There's a cave there, I think you can... Oh, no, wait, in the dark world!
So glad my shield worked there. Testa-tarts?
A Metroid and Zelda crossover is needed? Is it?
I always
Can you imagine space sci-fi Zelda?
Somebody's making a heck like that.
Really?
But it's also very Conker heavy. But it looks real cool.
Conker like Bad Fur Day?
Yeah. Hmm. Like I think he's the main character. But it's like a really impressive hack. Very technical. Shoot, what was I going to say?
A warp and another fairy. Okay, yeah. Okay. You will ask because the voice acting is very odd in the first Silent Hill. We could probably do an article on the voice acting, right?
Voice acting is hard to write about.
Oh, never mind.
Like, the few that I've written about, like, just I don't convey it very well. Mm-hmm. I need to find a better way to talk about voices.
Did you ever read about how they oriented every 3D model in A Link Between Worlds to an angle to show the way they do?
Yeah, I was talking about that earlier, how everything has to be at a crazy tilted. Have you seen it?
No.
I might have a screenshot of it somewhere. If someone has it handy. But everything, like Link is normal, but then everything else is just really tilted back. Like if you could go to the side.
Yeah.
And see it, everything is just tilted back.
Is it
to look this way?
Is it kind of like the trees in Ocarina of Time? You can basically tell they're just like this. Just like straight little things hooked together to look like a tree.
No, it's a little bit different.
Oh.
I think it is.
We're doing this right now?
Should we? Or do you want to keep exploring? Or do you want to end for
now? We only have 30 minutes.
Yeah, I don't think we can finish this today, but we'll do this tomorrow.
Yeah, but we can explore.
Okay, you want to explore?
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, there's some places I can go and talk, people I can talk to. Yeah, I'm usually done with the first palace by now.
You can see the angular orientation when you attach to some walls. Make an audiobook about voice acting. My favorite is House of the Dead 2. Don't come, don't come. I saw that in the Typing of the Dead.
All those arcade games, yeah, those shooting and light gun games, they have really, really bad dubs. Really like them. Oh, speaking of which, we got Chaos Wars, and I really want to play that someday.
We did?
Yeah, I bought it like 2 years ago so we could stream it, and then we never did. So let's go this way.
Can I play?
Okay, don't kill me.
You gotta not die first. Okay. What do you think happened here? Or is this drought. This just for like flavor, for spice?
There's a story behind it. That's where the mega bomb, they were testing those big bombs.
Oh, and
that's where it went off.
I remember something very well about A Link Between Worlds.
Read the sign.
Oh, doesn't it crash?
No.
Oh.
It's a gamble.
This way. So there's a down arrow right there.
Yeah.
I remember something. That octopus lady was in there.
Oh, that's right.
I went here a lot in A Link Between Worlds. I hate these birds.
Right, so pull.
Yes.
Go in there so I can get this picture.
Okay.
Right.
Whoa!
Alright, so here's what we were talking about.
Suffer like G did?
Alright. So I'm pulling up that picture from Link Between Worlds. We were talking with the person who named Link to the Past.
Mm-hmm.
So much good information. Did I not save it?
Oxford says, I think that thing that makes it crash is having a completely empty line in the first part of the text box.
Okay, I'll check it out. So here we go. Here is Link Between Worlds to make Link Between Worlds look like... make it look like this game. They have to do this.
Why?
For the perspective.
Really?
Yeah. So you're playing the whole game... Like the wind is coming.
The whole game looks like that?
Most of it.
How'd they get that angle?
You can just display everything that way.
Dang. No, I don't want nothing, lady. That coward bird. Uh-oh, I'm in trouble.
Yeah, I wanted to go in there.
Okay. Should I get a hint?
Yeah, let's just see what the hints are.
Do you see... What do you see here?
A ball.
I see an eyeball.
Oh, crap. I'm not unseeing that anymore.
You look like you might have an interesting destiny.
Okay.
May I tell your fortune? I'll make it cheap.
Step on a crack and you bring things back.
Hocus pocus, you will find a member of the wise men's line in the desert. Now I will take 30 rupees. I hope you will be healthy.
Got a papyrus laugh there. Go get the ice rod. I can do that already? Okay, I'll do that. Wait, are you serious?
I think you can.
Okay.
It's just difficult.
With this D-pad it is.
Isn't it that away?
So you have to go around.
Oh, yeah.
Ugh. Oh my god, I'm gonna get... No! The D-pad! I'm stuck! This is terrible.
I thought you didn't need to go this way, though.
Pretty sure you do. Am I wrong?
I don't think you need to go this way. Hmm. Like, you could have gone south. Yeah, I always saw that guy as an insane cultist. If we can just get one more heart, I'll feel safer.
Should I go back and go south? Because I'm pretty sure I have to go this way.
I mean, you can go this way, but... See, this is what happens when we both play the game.
Ooh, look! I never saw this, but that's a face!
Yeah.
This is what happens when married people play video games.
Those are faces, too, I never noticed.
Yeah, I saw those faces, but not those. That looks like a shark.
It's a double face.
A shark from Earthbound. Get out my way. Out my... Uh-oh. Do you have a fairy?
Yes, okay. One.
Am I wrong? I'm dead! They took away 2 hearts!
Probably shouldn't go there yet.
Okay.
Well, here's our fairy.
You gotta go... Kaz, you gotta go here.
Yeah.
See, you can't get there from there.
Okay. For some reason, I thought you could.
Maybe in the other game.
Darn you, other game. I remember going around that way a lot in the other game, so who knows.
Those things weird. Look at this weird... Uh-oh. What is that weird thing? That thing that blows up and has babies. Oh, these crabs. I'm gonna get in such trouble. And there's a Zort. Oh, and my D-pad. Uh-oh.
So I'm trying to read Yubel10's question. I want to know if the Japanese subs are as bad as the voice acting. I know that in Biohazard, the subs are better than the voice acting. So what game is that for?
Silent Hill, maybe? Did I do this right? Is this... Yeah! I did it!
Aw, there's text there.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm so used to... Here, you play.
No, it's okay. I'll just have to check the video. Because like, remember when you get the items, like that's where you get the MC Hammer line and stuff
yeah.
like that.
Yeah. I went into a different mode.
Pose and speedrun mode? Oh, you can get those guys.
Oh, right.
Although I'd probably touch one.
I will.
Touch fairy, get dizzy. So what's the deal with that fairy spelling? I've always been curious. I've just never looked into it. Like, why is it spelled one way and one sometimes and then the other way other times?
I need my boots.
Is that one way just like the old-timey way of spelling it? In Link's Awakening, the fire rod or the magic rod says burn, baby, burn. I have an article about that, yeah.
What is that line, Burden Baby Burn, from?
It's from a disco song, I think.
Oh yeah, Disco Inferno.
Oh man, she's gonna try to get a moth way up there.
I first heard it in Batman Returns, when the penguin did something and he said, Burn Baby Burn. And then like some stuff blew up, and then he blamed it on Batman or something.
I want a movie where every line of dialogue is just a one-liner.
I bet you they could make that happen on, like, whose line is it anyway?
Yeah, it's probably already been done, right?
I don't have the magic hammer, though.
Oh! It's okay. There should be a spin-off game of just those guys.
I like them, the choo-choos, but I don't think they're called choo-choos in this.
Choo-choo rocket.
They're cute. They look scary in the dark world, I think, or is it a link to the awakening?
So Spartanberry asks, are you going to let that the cat fight that one boss in the dark world? Which boss?
What cat?
One of our cats? Oh, the moth? Think. The moth.
Oh, yeah. Mothula.
So some of like our first memories of our cats is just sitting here right next to the monitor watching us play video games.
Yep.
They like video games. We'll play them out in the living room and they'll just stare at them.
Mm-hmm. If they're not like under the blankets. We make tents with our blankets and they like it. Where should I go?
Go over here to the desert.
Desert of mystery. Wait,
read that again. That works.
Okay.
It's more like suspicious. Desert of suspicion.
This guy. There's something about this guy.
Yeah, he gives you a bottle at some point, right? Wow, look at all those dots.
There's something... Man, when he finally talks, pay no attention to the average middle-aged man standing by his side.
So in Japanese it says, please don't talk to me. I am a strange middle-aged man. And please don't paint on the sign.
Leave him alone. Don't paint
on it. Oh, no, don't paint on it. Don't pull it.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Did it say that in English? Don't pull it?
No.
Oh, okay.
Why'd you take my sign?
He just says, why?
Hmm.
In Japanese. Paint. I think I was thinking of... Yeah, just a verb that's almost similar.
I hate these birds!
Yeah, they suck in the other game, too. You got the eight crab.
Where do I take... Is that blind?
In Link Between Worlds, you couldn't go into the desert yet.
He's gone.
Yay. And
These vultures.
Now we're in Dusty Dunes.
This is my trick for the vultures. Oh, wait, there's a bomb.
Oh, wow. That's a good trick.
Oh, no.
So those are called guilds.
I died.
But in Japanese, it's basically the exact same word as Gerudo.
Really?
Yeah. So maybe those people are like...
These are the Gerudos?
Yeah.
Gross. I don't want to go in this desert. It's dangerous.
So there's, the barcode battler? There's a whole Zelda 3 game that you can play. It has like a whole complete set of cards and like I think like some sort of special way to play. Thanks for coming by, Nuka-Cola.
I think when I have the power mitts, I can do something better. That guy, I can lift those up or something.
Don't you feel very weak with this controller?
Yes.
That's the way to make games hard again, is just play with a bad controller. Wow, that was neat.
Where should I explore next? Because I'm running out of stuff to do.
We can end soon if you'd like. Just,
Oh man, when I figured this out...
Yeah.
When I figured out that warp, I felt so smart. Oh, you know what I'm thinking of? You can go here and go into the dark world in the other game.
So there's that cave over here, maybe?
Yeah.
Right here?
The fairy. I opened it up. No.
Well, I mean, there's a cave right here in Link Between Worlds. I just don't remember if there's one here.
I'm gonna heal my hearts and then go try to make this guy... Because his text always was weird.
Which guy?
The guy in the grass who's jumping up and down.
Oh, he has text?
Mm-hmm.
So, Pacina has a lot of text here. Link will swing his sword with his left hand except when he's facing... So he says like, darn it, take it, thief. Or like, damn it, take it, thief.
Is this a bunny or something?
I don't know what it is. Here's a page 143. Link will swing his sword with his left hand except when he's facing to the east. No one is exactly sure why Link employs this right-handed technique when he faces the east. Some say it is a boyish superstition that makes Link hold a shield toward Death Mountain when battling a foe to east or west. Link is sure that the evil power is originating from Death Mountain. So is that a legit line from...
Look! You mean like this? Yeah. He does look right-handed here. Yeah. It's just a mirrored sprite.
Page 143? It's not in this guide, is it? Oh, it might be. Oh, you're right. In this guide, this clear guide...
They made up some lore.
Yeah. They explain why Link... where is it? Link is left-handed. So I never owned this guide as a kid.
Me either.
So I gotta read through it and memorize it. Kind of like if you were just gonna study a book or read a book for a class. That's how I'm taking the Zelda stuff. I'm gonna read like the comics and these guides. We have a bunch of smelly, smoky guides I gotta read.
Oh, that's right. Bah! Oh, right, I have that.
Oh, yeah. It's not very helpful in this game. I think there's one enemy it's really good against, isn't there? I thought there was one.
I'm gonna check on this Ocarina boy, and then maybe can stop.
Yeah, it's a good stopping point. And then we can get to the meat of the game next time.
I always tried to, like, sneak up on him and try to get as close as possible. Mm-hmm. He used to come over here.
It's Link.
And just sit here and listen to his song. They could have made Link look like that.
That bunny is evil looking.
Couldn't they have made Link look like that?
Yeah, probably. Should have made him have the pink hair. So how does he, like, how's he phasing in from the other world?
Animal magic. So you want to save?
Sure. Save and quit. And I'm going to save state it. Here. All right, so today we got through the intro and the prologue. We crashed my program a few times. I got to go fix that. It's like the first time it's really ever crashed, I think.
Mm-hmm.
And we learned a lot of things. I learned a lot of new things. So I hope you guys will join us tomorrow and teach me new things.
Oh, look, it's doing it up there.
Yep. Here, let me see. Yep, there we go. And I'll see if I can improve things, make it work. And tomorrow we'll do the actual first dungeon.
Yeah.
And then some more. And I think some story stuff starts to happen after that, right? Like with a lot more text.
Yes, I think so. All right.
All right, so see you.
So tomorrow, 5 p.m. Arizona time, 4 p.m. Pacific, 7 p.m. Eastern. Y'all chumps that do daylight saving time.
So check us out, follow us, and send us your pies, please. Until tomorrow.
And stick around for the credits, because you're in them.
Bye, everybody.